Good morning to the Philippines. As y'all are waking up, I am putting out this video on purpose. Before I get into the video, hit that thumbs up, hit that sub, hit that bell. You know what to do. Support the channel. Leave a comment too, because I always respond. With that being said, let's get into this. Who does Manny Pacquiao fight next? Is it going to be Errol Spence Jr., Bud Crawford, or is it going to be Conor McGregor from the UFC? I'm going to tell y'all right now who he's fighting next. Whoever the fuck he wants to, that's who Manny fights next. Whoever he chooses. Because no matter what people say about Errol Spence being the A side, the Terence Crawford's B side, no matter what people try to say about who the man of the division is, there's only one man of the welterweight division, and that is Manny Pacquiao. Pac-Man is on top. And if these guys want to fight Pac-Man and get the biggest payday of their life, they'll take whatever Pac-Man decides to give them. That's how it goes when you're fighting somebody like Pacquiao, when you want to get in there with somebody like Pacquiao. Pacquiao is the man of the division, and I would assume that he's going to fight whoever the hell he wants. And that's just the way it's going to go. So do I think he'll fight Errol Spence Jr.? Yeah, if he wants to. Do I think he'll fight Bud Crawford? Yeah, if he wants to. Do I think he'll fight Conor McGregor? Nah, I don't see that happening. The reason why I say that is Conor McGregor's coach was questioned about the fight. He said it potentially could happen, but they're training for, I believe his name was Dustin Poirier. So that fight's coming up in January of next year. So that definitely takes him off the ballot or even being a choice as a competitor against Manny Pacquiao. So with that being said, you got two main front runners. What will Manny do? I don't know. What will he do? He'll do whatever he wants to do. And whoever he picks, I'm satisfied with it because I think Manny trumps all. So as much as I would like to see Spence versus Crawford, I think if Manny picks Spence, that's who Spence should fight. I think if Manny picks Bud, Bud should fight Manny, and that fight would get delayed. That's what I think. Now, for Manny, I think it would be smartest to make those two fight, and then you take off the winner. You let them beat each other up, then you beat the winner, then you become undisputed. And one fight versus having to have two more to be undisputed. But there's no guarantee that Spence will fight Bud. So with that being said, we know Manny will fight anybody. He takes on all comers. He is not scared. He has never been scared. And he has taken the hard way. And because he's taken the hard way and traveled that rough path, that road nobody wants to go down, that is why his legacy will be remembered forever. That is what makes him great. No matter if he wins or he loses, that is what makes him great, because Manny dares to be great. And even at 41 years old, he just dusted off somebody who was thought of as good at the welterweight division, Keith One-Time Thurman. Not only did he dust him off, but he put him on his butt with them little bitty T-Rex arms, or so Keith thought he had, which he found out he did not. Manny is very fast. He's very good. Who do I think he does better against? That's a hard one. It's a very hard one between Spence and Bud, because Bud will outreach Spence because he's got incredibly long arms. However, Spence will throw a lot more punches than Bud, whereas Bud will be looking to counter. I don't know which stylistically is better for Manny. I'm leaning more towards Errol Spence only because when guys start to move, I don't think he does as good against them. And Manny is very good at lateral movement and throwing punches from crazy angles that should not be thrown. Somehow he finds a way to make them land. And not only do they land, but they have power, as Keith learned when he was on his butt, wondering how he got down there. You got down there because you talked about a great, talked about a legend. So really, that's all I got to say on this video is Manny's going to do whatever Manny wants to do. And nobody can criticize Manny because Manny has done everything there is to do. Manny has fought everybody, anybody has ever wanted him to fight. Not only did he do that, but he tried to fight all of them when they were at their best. He didn't try to put clauses on them. He didn't try to put weird shit in the contract. No, Manny went for the best when they were the best. And whether he won or lost, he still went in there and fought against them. And for that, he will ever be remembered as one of the greatest to do it. Manny is a legend. He's an amazing boxing star. Like, there's no way to get around it. And because of his accolades, because of his history, Manny's going to fight whoever he wants to fight. Again, I think he would be, I don't know if he beats Bud or Spence, but I think he has more of a shot against Spence than he does against Bud, in my opinion. Now, you could say, well, you don't agree with me because Spence is naturally bigger than Bud. Bud came from a lighter division, and because Bud came from a lighter division, it may be easier for Manny as he'll be fighting a smaller guy. And I wouldn't argue with that. I would not argue with anybody making an argument that Spence is a harder fight or anybody making an argument that Bud's a harder fight. I would not argue with your argument on this aspect. But in my personal opinion, I think Manny Pacquiao has more of a shot at beating Errol Spence Jr. than he does Bud Crawford stylistically. And again, he'll fight whoever he wants to fight. And if he wants to fight Conor McGregor, then it probably wouldn't happen until March of next year. So, you know, there's that. If he does choose to fight him, why not? Mayweather did it. Mayweather got a paycheck off of it. Why not Manny get a big paycheck? I'm not mad at Manny or whatever he does. I don't care if Manny fights Sam that drives the Ubers from down the street. If Mayweather can get away with it, if Mayweather deserves it, then so does Manny, because Manny's done everything that Mayweather's done as well. So whomever he picks, it's his choice, and that's who he deserves to fight. Let me know what y'all think in the comments section. Again, I will restate where I like to say I begin. I think Manny Pacquiao has a better shot at beating Errol Spence Jr. than he does Bud Crawford. And I think that is the fight for him to make. And if he does choose to fight Errol Spence Jr., in my opinion, that trumps Bud Crawford. And again, I will restate, if Manny picks to fight Bud Crawford, then that trumps Errol Spence Jr. because the real A-side to the welterweight division is Manny Pacquiao. Oh yeah, I had to jump back on to say this. Don't forget to hit up that comment section. Don't forget to leave a comment, because I will respond to everybody, whether you agree or disagree with me. I will always respond to you. Now, let me end the video this time on this note with Manny cheesing on the whole welterweight division.